we're about to take you on a journey. A journey that will literally take us to the edge. Nearly 64% of Pacific people in New Zealand are obese. It's a serious issue in our community. We're over halfway through the series. We need to see results, so we've decided to put our money where our mouth is and walk the talk.
I've just come back from holiday and I had a good one.
I think he's gliding a bit.
I can't have break days anymore. Unfortunately, I'll use them all up.
We've run, boxed and sweat through the last 6 weeks of the Walk the Talk Healthy Living Movement series. We've all put our bodies on the line to lose weight and get healthy. This week, we find out if it's all been worth the pain. For our halfway health checks, we'll take a visit back to West Whānau to measure our weight and body fat percentage. But first, we're all booked in for a beep test with Samoan personal trainer Mark Michaels to check our fitness levels halfway into the series.
I'm going to introduce you to the beep test. Now, the beep test comprises of 21 levels.
And I look at the length of the room, and the cone is on this side, and the other cone is like all the way up in Manukau.
First level is pretty slow, second level gets slightly faster and faster. Really just going to the point of exhaustion, and then we'll work out what levels you are at this stage.
Our boss, Stephen, has tagged along in support of the Walk the Talk team.
How fast do you have to run, and how do you know how fast
you
run?
You just have to run, listen to the beats. Okay.
Okay. I am a little nervous.
I'm really nervous about the beep test. I've never done one before. My competitive spirit means that I kind of want to do well. Definitely want to beat Stephen.
Weird feeling, a little bit nervous actually. Don't know why, I shouldn't really be nervous about it, but I am. I know I haven't trained as hard as everyone else over the last 6 weeks, so could get exposed here.
The two heavyweights of the team are sitting out this beep test due to medical conditions and injury.
It's the old gammy knee excuse. Can't run, I can cycle.
I was having some chest pains, and I thought I'll still come down, and I'll ask Mark what he thinks. And his diagnosis was, if I'm having chest pains, flag it.
But for the rest of us, there's no escaping the inevitable.
The test starts in 5 seconds.
Remember, get into a rhythm pretty quickly. In through the nose, out through the mouth.
Level 1-6.
Try and time it just before the beep. You have 1 foot over the line, push off the line.
Level 3-8.
One more arm up.
Start level 4-1.
New level, new intensity. The speed creeps up a bit. First warning. Come on, Marama.
I was like, I've got to work through the pain barrier. I've got to keep going. But then the trainer guy said, you stop now. Apparently, I'd been given about 3 warnings. I didn't hear them because I was trying to work through my pain barriers. I've got a long way to go with my fitness.
Now give me 7.
Our boss, Stephen, has lost 26 kilos in the last 10 months through strict diet and exercise, but surprisingly, he's the next one to drop.
Stephen, was he there?
Level 6-5.
First warning, come on, try and make the line. Trying to get to 7, that's it.
He got his warning at level 5, and I thought, well, okay, here we go. I've got this clown. And then we get to the next level, and he's still there, and I'm going, well, how much more has he got left?
Push, push, push. That's it.
I don't care about anyone else. This is about me getting to that cone and back.
8. 2 more. Give me 2 more.
2.
Come on, Laurie.
This is a guy who done no training whatsoever before this 12-week challenge. And to get to the level of fitness he's at, I'm actually really surprised.
That's harder than I thought.
Ex-fitness instructor Nairi is the next to go. But it's not over till it's over. And there's still one man standing.
Start level 8-1.
Yes, 8-1.
harder than I thought. I was feeling it from one.
I'm happy that I was normal. I think I was gauged as normal fitness, but I think I could have pushed myself harder had Nairi not dropped out. I am happy in the end.
8.7.
Excellent, bro.
With a gauge on our fitness levels, it's time to get to the West Fornal Clinic once again to check our midway weight and body fat percentage. Although Adrian aced the beep test, he's unsure whether his luck will carry through.
This is where the real results will be seen, and that's why I'm slightly more worried about this, because now we will see who's been working and who hasn't.
John's training with the ringside program has been intense, but he's got no indication of how much weight he's lost.
119,500. So I'm happy, on track. Obviously, something's working.
Your percentage body fat was 142, now it's 114, which is really good.
That's a good number.
That's a very good number. You are doing a marvellous job. Keep up the hard work.
This is one doctor visit. I didn't mind.
Yeah. Nairi's regime has been mostly on track. However, her social drinking has remained the same over the past 6 weeks, which has her anxious about her results.
So how's it been 6 weeks later?
Mm-hmm. Food's been all right. Still drinking
the wine.
All your measurements compared to last time have actually come down a lot. The percentage body fat for you has dropped from 42% to 36.7%.
Yay! The body fat percentage was a big thing for me because mine was so high. It was a good way of telling that I'd done the work.
All right, here we go.
Osoni is about to find out if his exercise and controversial diet are helping him peel off the fat.
Well done. 17 kilos lost. 6 weeks.
Woohoo! Down 17 kilos, 4% body fat drop. So.
Good 5 minutes. Awesome.
Thank you, thank you.
I'm hoping a few extra push ups will get me a similar result to a Swanee's.
Last minute training.
Oh, yeah. That's all right, eh? Yes. I feel different.
Yeah. More energy?
Yeah, more energy and stuff.
Your percentage body fat now is 35.8%. Awesome. So you've lost 5 kilos in weight and lost 6% off.
Wow.
The body fat. Well done.
Thank you.
Keep up the good work.
Cool.
Back in the waiting room, Adrian's luck has run out. He's next in line for the scales of truth.
I was feeling for him because I know he was really nervous. He wanted to have a good result. It was quite amusing to see him sweat, though.
You don't have anything heavy in your pockets, do you?
Nope.
No. Your percentage body fat is now 25.5%.
So what am I going
to? Down from 31%, which is really good. So you're getting...
Oh, this is remarkable.
This is... See? And you've gone down 5 kilos.
That's great. I'll take that. I just couldn't believe it. I was so surprised that I lost 6%. It's massive.
Rookie journalist JP is hoping that his community exercise has helped to shave down the bulge.
109. Yes.
But for JP, the good news is short-lived.
Even though your weight has gone down, for some reason your percentage body fat is actually higher than what it was last time. It's a bit unusual.
Are you serious? Mm. So my weight has gone down, but my body fat has gone up. Mm. It's quite the most shocking thing to find out that, you know, you've done the hard yards and, you know, you find out that something else has gone wrong, you know, that you need to do more. So it's quite disappointing. I've been through, you know, the runs, you know, and been poked by the doctor, you know, and things like that, but yeah.
So, at a glance, the whole team has lost a combined weight of 55 kilos. Everyone has gone down in body fat percentage, except for JP. His body fat has increased.
Because he hasn't been doing a lot of resistance training, that would probably explain why he has the 1% increase rather than decrease.
Next time on Walk the Talk.
The idea was to have a healthy team lunch. So what does John Poole bring? Fatty patties and chicken schnitzel. I see it's on his plate and Marama's plate. People are wondering why his body percentage has gone up. Well, I'm starting to get some indicators.